Sup guys, it's me, Cheesus Bree here with more Dangan Ronpa. Chapter 4, kind of. We're gonna go from the end of chapter 3 on to the new one. Or I'm just gonna skip to chapter 4, I don't know. Future me will know that. So yeah, let's get right into it. Right now we're at the ending of chapter 3. Leon killed Sayaka. Monokuma killed Junko. Then Leon got executed. Then Mondo killed Shihiro. And then he got executed. Hifumi killed Taka. Then Celeste killed Hifumi. And she got executed. And that brings us up to now. Chapter 4. Good morning! The next morning, in the dining hall, the day after Celeste's case. So now there's only 5 of us here. Only a third of the number of people we started with.
Indeed.
Loneliness has become commonplace. I like how she's like, loneliness has become commonplace. That's true! Still. What did I see yesterday? I don't understand. Sayaka is the mastermind spy? Dun dun dun! Can that really be true? Makoto, are you okay? I'm fine. I can't bring it up in front of the others. If I did that, it would just confuse everyone just that much more.
Okay,
in that case, that's it till we pass out. Huh? Donuts? What do you mean in that case?
Cause
look how scary everyone looks. It's gotta be cause we're all fighting on empty stomachs, right? If you fill your belly, I'm sure you'll all cheer up. So let's eat.
Okay.
Let's fry up some fish and donuts and eat till we can't stand up. I love Asahina. Aoi Asahina.
What?
That's like a deep impact style, meteor impact, extinction level event, combination of foods.
Huh?
What? They're both breakfast time best top sellers. Still, the till we can't stand up part is a problem. After we're done, we need to go explore.
That's right,
since the class trial is over, new areas should be opened up.
It's true.
Plus, we still have alter ego. We don't have to give in to the despair yet. She's right. We have a plan ahead and think about the future.
Yeah,
think happy thoughts. No deathy thoughts, not deathy thoughts.
You know?
Like, when we're gonna get out of here, right? When is this all over? I think I wanna get reborn for serious. Reborn as someone serious. He's like, me too. Hey, are you okay? That sounds like something someone who's about to die would say. I'm totally okay. I'm not gonna die. Why? Cause there aren't gonna be any more murders. What makes you so sure?
I predicted it
last night, since it revealed itself to me from the ether. There's no doubt about it.
However,
how accurate is your fortune telling anyway?
I
can usually hit 20 or 30% on a good day. Me too. That seems pretty low. Out of 10.
It's not like some occult mystery.
My wires are tangled. Yeah, it's not like it's ESP or whatever. Of course I'm only gonna get it right sometimes. Like how I predicted 9/11. I feel like Yasuhiro actually predicted 9/11. I would like that. He's the guy that predicted 9/11. I told you, my fortune telling isn't like some occult thing.
So,
fortune telling isn't occult?
You got it all
wrong. Of course
wrong.
Not. Clairvoyance is clairvoyance. I don't put it in the same category as cattle mutilation.
Huh?
Cattle what?
So
he's referring to the urban legend where aliens abduct cows and dissect them into as parts of their research.
Actually,
No, you're calling it an urban legend. As a matter of fact, it's true. As a matter of fact, it happened to me. It all happened one day when I went to go get a hamburger. It was a place I'd never seen before. They claimed their patties were 100% all beef. So I got a burger and headed home.
But
before long, The sky was filled with a mysterious blinding light.
Some crazy beam came out of nowhere and locked onto my hamburger.
I'm done.
And as soon as the beam touched it, the burger started floating in midair. And then, still floating there, the entire burger started coming apart. One part of it just vanished, while the rest fell back into my hand.
The burger!
Do you realize what that means?
What does that mean, Hero?
It means the burger wasn't 100% beef. It must have had some pork or something mixed in.
I'm done.
Something like 70% pork and 30% beef would be my guess. You can't trick me.
So I stormed into the burger place, got up in the manager's grill, and they totally admitted it. It wasn't 100% beef. They totally mixed in ground pork with it.
How about
now,
that?
Now do you see? That is cattle mutilation. I kind of got lost halfway through. Okay, I'm like, woo! Technical difficulties. I can't tell if you're for the occult or against it. You stink of stupidity.
Don't be mean.
I stink of, how dare you? Well, you do stink though. That's fine. That's fine? Anyways, I hope your prediction turns out to be true. Well, at least I won't murder anyone.
Yeah.
Me neither. I mean, I would never.
Of course. Me either.
Indeed.
Nor I. That goes for me, too. Of course, I could never kill any of my friends. I felt like those words of encouragement were helping us come together as one. After so much sacrifice and hardship, we finally became united. But,
well,
to be honest, I wish Byakuya and Toko were here for this, too. And I just got a notification. Oh, nope, that's a video. Fuck you, Abby. Fuck you.
But
they're so hard to deal with. They only think about themselves. Because they're sociopaths. So am I. Yeah, we're better off without them, I say. That was enough to prove we were united for the time being. But within that bond hid weakness and fragility. Fragile! It's French! All-Star Apologies, Chapter 4. We began our search as soon as we'd finished our breakfast in the dining hall. We had to find out what happened, what had opened up, what was waiting for us. Our hope. Back to this. Leave this area, heck. I have to go this way. Wait. Oh, yeah, wait, it's still not open. I forgot. Whoa! Is it this way? No, it's 2B. 2B or not 2B? That is the question. It's back this way? Yeah, it's right here. Are 3A through B. Where's the fourth? There is a fourth floor. I remember seeing it. I think it was over here. Is this the physics hallway? No, that's just physics. Aha, there is the fourth. I saw the wrong one. Yeah, it's right here. Oh my god, what are you doing? Okay. So now we have access to the fourth floor of Hope Speak Academy. Maybe this time we'll find some clue. No! This time I have to find it. I pressed X. What is up here? So music. Student government, Monokuma's room. I have a feeling I want to go to the data lab. Rattle, rattle, no good, the door's locked. I guess I won't be getting in here. According to the nameplate, this is called the data center. But what's behind this door is a total mystery. So I guess I will go to, this chem lab. I'm guessing it's the chem lab. And access to the fifth floor, because every school needs five floors. This is chemistry. There's Aoi and Sakura. This is the chem lab. Yeah, I was right. It was the chem lab. I hope inhaling all this stuff doesn't do permanent damage. No, that's only Earth's bio. That's bio. Hina and Sakura seem to be lost in deep but friendly conversation. I need to find out what's going on with Sakura and the mastermind, but I can't while she's with Hina.
Hey, Makoto.
Huh? You need something? No, it's something.
Huh?
You sure? Okay, then. Okay. I have to look throughout this whole room. It's a remarkably big shelf, and it's stocked with all kinds of medicine.
That's right!
Hey, listen, Makoto, listen! Just take a deep breath and calm down, and listen to me! Okay, Hina, just chill out. There's all kinds of stuff we didn't have before. Vitamins, minerals, amino acids, keratin,
okay.
And wait! They even have Proteinazyme X? What's that?
Hey.
It's a high-quality protein drink. It's nothing like that cheap swill in the warehouse. It's connoisseur level. Oh, yeah. This is an amazing. It's a gold mine. My prayers have been finally answered. Time to load up some more prayers, then. A gold mine, huh? I just dropped my controller. What else is there? This thing? No. Boiler? No. Chemistry? No. Sakura, Origami. What is it, Makoto? Did you need something? No, it's nothing.
So
really?
Then.
Well, okay. She knows what's up. Camera, give me some Monokuma points. Surveillance camera. Yeah! 247! Leave this area? Heck. So. That way is down. This way. This is the office. I could get into the office. Anybody in here? But there is a picture. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! The picture! picture. I saw a little bit of it. No! But of course, there's no hint of any teachers that we'd normally be able to reply on. No! Not the picture! Oh, that's a different picture. There's a different picture. Huh? There's a picture on the floor. This picture. Wait! What? Celeste Fumi and Sakuya? Sayaka? The smiling faces of three people who are dead now? A classroom without metal plates over all the windows? The fuck? It's exactly the same. That picture makes me want to cry. It's that picture. I forgot we already found that picture. It's just like the picture I saw before. There's no way this is important somehow. But take it anyway. They're smiling. The way you'd expect is normal teenagers to smile. They're just a normal group of high schoolers living a normal school life. I can't possibly believe they were able to smile like that in a world of despair like this. So does that mean this picture was taken before they came to Hope Speak? Which would mean everyone in this picture knew each other before they got here, including Sayaka. There's no way Monokuma did this. It must be a fake. Yeah. You're fake! Monokuma popped out of nowhere and snatched the picture from my hand. A forgery plot? What are you, a middle schooler? You think the moon landing was fake too? Come on! Then you're saying this picture is... Oh, then you're saying this picture is real?
Hey!
If there's such thing as a Nobel Truth Prize, I take first, second, and fourth place. Actually, that's probably not true. I asked you a question. Is this picture real or is it a fake? Oh, fuck! Oh, Makoto, you're so eager to split things in half, aren't you?
Hey,
But it's no use. It's just no use. If you try to split something that can't be split, you end up feeling like you're the one being split.
It's
the picture
true.
Is real. No more, no less. And he leaves. Without another word, Monokuma disappeared. Son of a bitch! It's really real, if that's true. In that case, that's the case, I must look at this box. I must look at this basket. I must look. Why are there just flowers? Is everyone dead? Yee! What about this? Is this the same? Oh my god, each one has freaking... Oh my god, this is a gold mine. What's over here? Nothing. What's over here? Leave the area. Okay, so what is over here? Headmaster. Is it locked? The nameplate on the door says Headmaster Room. The Headmaster's Room. This must be something. There must be something worthwhile in here. Rattle, rattle. The door's locked. Damn it. Dang it. And let's go to the music room. Hi, ho, the music room. The music room. Music room. Music. Music room. I love music. This is a big area. Does that mean everyone else is in here? Nope. This is the music room. It's hardly even a classroom. It's more like an actual concert hall. The piano. The piano knows something I don't know. It's really old. I bet it's worth a lot of money. Of course, without someone around to play it, it's totally useless. Ha ha! Monokuma points. 250. 250. What does Saya... No.
Hey.
Kirigiri have to say. You know, you haven't told me what you think yet. What I think?
So...
About the secret room in the boys' bathroom. Ah, well, I did find the secret room, but as soon as I started looking around, I was attacked.
What?
Attacked by who? Well, they came from behind, and I didn't have any time to react, so I didn't see who it was. And when I came to, the mountains of files and documents were all gone. I'm sorry, I know how important those were.
That's fine.
It's okay. I already saw what I needed it to in there.
I had half suspected
the mastermind might come after you. What?
Because
when I discovered that room, the mastermind must have seen me on surveillance cameras in the hallway. Then must have seen you go in the boys' bathroom and never come out. Still, I wanted you to go and see it. I wanted to see how the mastermind would react. Essentially, I wanted to find out if the mastermind actually knew about that room.
But
to attack you and steal everything in the room, that must mean there was some unknown clue in there that could reveal the mastermind's identity. Then you knew I was gonna get attacked?
You can't handle
that kind of thing, though, right? After all, you're a boy. What is that? What does she think a boy is? Fine, I understand. Then let me ask you something else. Do you know about the note that was left in there? The note that says, you must not leave?
Just a second.
We shouldn't talk about that. Not here. Kyoko stole a...
So...
I'm looking into it. If I find anything out, I'll let you know.
Listen,
is that okay? She made it sound like she was asking, but it was clear I wouldn't have any say in the matter. Not yawning, I swear. I'm not tired. Well, I kind of am, but I'm not that tired. So now it's your turn. Let's hear your secret. Huh? Did you think I wouldn't notice? You're hiding something.
Am I wrong?
She's smiling. That's... Okay.
What?
What's the matter? If you're worried about the camera, why not just write it down?
Hey.
We're friends. So you should be able to trust me. Isn't that what you said before? You're right! God dang it! Tell her, because then she might elaborate. I haven't found exclusive evidence yet, but if I talk about it now, it could just make things worse. Friends shouldn't keep secrets, but there's nothing... Tell her! Oh, I'm not actually supposed to tell her? Sorry, I can't tell you. Not yet.
Correct.
So that's your answer.
However...
But you do think that's fair. You were happy to hear what I had to say, and now you're unwilling to share? I'm sorry, I really am.
That's fine. Goodbye.
And those were... With those as their parting words, Kyoko left me standing there alone. I think I made her mad. I've already taken a good look around here. There's a lot to think about, but I should go back to the dining hall. Okay. I have no idea what time I started this episode. I have no idea what time I got home. I'm just gonna, it's only been 23 minutes. Okay. Not long after I got to the dining hall, the others began to trickle in. After a few minutes... So, is everyone here?
Well...
Okay, let's discuss what we discovered. Yeah, good idea. Starting from the right side of the room. Okay, Kyoko? She's ignoring me.
So,
Hey, Makoto. Did Kyoko seem upset to you?
That's right!
Is she? Isn't she? She's totally mad! Yeah, looks like it.
What's your deal?
I bet it's your fault, isn't it? You must have done something to her. Ah, this is bad. Okay, let's start from the other side of the room.
Yeah.
There was a big shelf in the chem lab on the fourth floor, and it had all kinds of chemicals and stuff.
Okay.
And there was an all-star cast of nutrient additives and supplements. You should at least take a peek. I highly recommend it. I think you and Ogre are probably the only ones interested in that stuff. Oh, but it's not all good stuff, though. There was some medicine and health stuff on the top. But on top of that, there's also a bunch of different poisons. Poison! They were all labeled clearly, though. So it would be hard to grab one by mistake.
It's true.
Still, we'd better make sure we're careful around there. And we probably shouldn't tell Byakuya or Toko about that poison, right?
Huh?
What do you mean?
Well,
just in case. You know what I'm trying to say. Just in case. Yeah, I think you're right.
However,
it's Byakuya. It won't be long before he's discovered it by himself. But to put something as dangerous as poison right out in the open, that's absolutely the work of the mastermind. Gosh darn it, the mastermind. I found a couple of rooms on the first floor, but they were locked, the data center and the headmaster's room. The headmaster's room? That sounds like exactly the place we want to find some clues. If we can somehow unlock the door and get inside,
but
who cares? It's about a stupid lock.
How about
no problem with the world's strongest missing link to knock down one measly door. What was that? No, please, continue. Did you say I've got the nicest butt on the block? The curviest hips in town? Is that what you said? Monokuma, you're a bear!
What the hell?
Hell no, I didn't!
Hey,
then what did you say?
Because
I know you weren't talking about tearing down the door to the headmaster's room. Knocking down your headmaster's door? What kind of war on education are you trying to start here?
Your teacher
That's
had such
my room,
you
know. It is now. It is now, anyway.
Betrayal?
And you're thinking of busting it down? You seriously don't want to piss me off. You have any idea how much bacteria lives on a single bear claw? I know, I was just kidding. Please don't get mad. I'm not mad! You're totally mad.
This is kind of depressing.
I was hoping I wouldn't have to add a rule for this. But if you're gonna go around having those thoughts, I have no choice but to add to the school regulations. Seriously.
Too bad.
Breaking down a locked door is prohibited. There! That's a rule now, you jerks! And my thing is rolled on. Oh, no, it's not. Come on, get out. Come on, get out. Okay, there we go. It was stuck underneath the broken wheel. Because my chair has a broken wheel and I need a new desk. I need, a bigger desk and a new chair. That's on my to-do list, getting a L-shaped desk. Let me make sure that's plugged in. An L-shaped desk and a new chair. And not lean on it. The new rule has been added to regulations. Is he gone?
Yeah.
And I was scared for my life. I was sure he was gonna kill me for serious.
Well.
But if he would go out of his way to make up a rule like that, there's no doubt there's something important must be hidden in the headmaster's room. But now that it's a rule, there's nothing we can do. Sakura, Origami, what do you gotta say? Metal sheets have been attached to the windows on the fourth floor. None of them budged an inch.
In other words,
just like everywhere else, escape from the fourth floor seems unlikely. That was to be expected, though. So, has everyone said what they needed to say? I think so.
For serious?
But it looks like nobody found any clues at all, let alone a way to out of here. I haven't been this depressed since my house burned down to the ground. Someone, do something to cheer me up. Can I say something?
How about that?
It's because my dad was smoking in bed. Nobody asked. That's no. I have something I'd like to report. So, you guys all remember, right? You remember when I found that picture on the third floor the other day?
Perhaps.
You mean the one that showed Mondo, Shihiro, and Leon all together, right?
Huh?
Yeah, I rem- remember it. What about it? Well, I found another one. Another picture almost just like that one. Huh? Another one? But this time, the picture was of Celeste, Hifumi, and Sayaka! Ah! Huh? And they were all smiling. And the classroom in the picture didn't have any metal covering the windows. It was happy. So the picture of Mondo, Shihiro, and Leon wasn't the only one. Now you found that one that had Celeste, Hifumi, and Sayaka.
But
how can that...
Conspiracy!
Monokuma must have faked it! But if the picture is real, then everyone who was in it... There would have been some kind of hidden connection there, don't you think? Some deeper truth that we just don't understand.
What?
Can't be! It's a fake! But Monokuma said it was real. I know we could just write it off as a lie, but...
So then?
Then you trust Monokuma's word over the people who have died? What?
Because...
That's what you're saying, isn't it? No, it's not it. I'm shocked. You told everyone how we should believe in our friends, but you refused to do the same. That's not... What's going on, Kyoko? Why are you getting so emotional? I don't understand why she's so angry.
Hey, come on.
Come on, guys. Stop fighting. Or all your good luck's gonna float away. Anyway, Makoto. You're thinking about it too much. There's no way Monokuma didn't fake that picture.
Of course.
He's just trying to confuse us. You shouldn't listen to anything Monokuma has to say. You might be right, but still. Are you still so conflicted?
What?
It looks like you guys have stopped playing nice. The Akuya! You all have the same sunken look on your faces. You were all so ugly before. You shouldn't let them sink any lower. When I look at you, it makes me think of a frog sinking in a pile of manure.
You know?
Sorry?
Just a second.
Why are you apologizing? Leave us alone. You're not a part of this.
That's right.
True enough. Your problems aren't mine. We are, and always will be, completely separate. So whatever's causing your faces to turn so ugly has absolutely nothing to do with me. And if that happened to... And if I happened to discover a vital clue, it wouldn't concern you in the slightest. Huh? Did he finally say something useful?
Hey.
Byakuya, what have you been up to?
That's fine.
I don't mind telling you. Perhaps forcing your lazy brains to get to work might do you some good.
Such ignorance.
I was in the bath. Okay. Okay. I'm confused on why my thingy just updated. He was taking a bath. Are you Murdoch'd from Gorillas? The bar! Hey guys, I'm going to take a bath. My 3DS is still on. What game do I have in here? Mario Kart. For DS. Shut up. I forgot I was playing that. Is he saying he's been talking to alter ego? Did he tell him something?
It would seem.
Maybe we should all go take a bath. Good idea. A mixed bath?
Okay.
A mixed bath! If alter ego did tell him something, I wonder what it could have been. I just farted. The bath! The bath! The bath! I like how there's just random slippers. Toko! Fukawa! Toko was sitting alone on a bench, the laptop in front of her. Toko, did you decide to come here? Hear what alter ego has to say too?
What's
I already heard
problem?
It with Master. With Master! don't have to keep saying it anyway. So what are you doing right now? Shut up. Stop bothering me.
How about that?
Yeah, the way we have to talk to Alter Ego.
Whoa.
No, I made a master a promise. A promise? Master told me to wait here, so that's what I'm doing.
Huh?
What are you, his dog? If that's what Master wants, then I'll do anything he asks. You sound like my friend, and I'm scared. You just love being mistreated. Well, fine. If you really want me gone, by all means.
What?
Hey, guys! What's going on?
Yes!
Sure thing! Kneel before me and beg!
What?
First a mega masochist, now a super sadist. Okay, let's go straight to Alter Ego. Genocide Jack is sitting in front of the laptop. I can't get to it. Toko, seriously, I'm asking you nicely to let us use the laptop.
You SOB!
I love the freaking...
How about
come on, Makoto, give her the old 1-2 combo. One, drop a... One, drop to your knees. Two, beseech. Why are you acting like you're not a part of this? I was desperate, I felt. Please, I'm begging you, will you let us use the laptop?
Oh, I'm on fire!
Such an ultra-miraculous feeling of happiness. All my pent-up anger at Master for abusing me is evaporating. So even you realize it's abuse.
Hey.
That should be enough, right? Hurry up and let us talk to Alter Ego. Okay! Where'd she go? Oh, she's just over there, just like... Everyone, come closer. I already told Byakuya, but I was finally able to crack open all the files that were on this laptop. So, sorry to have kept you all waiting.
Correct.
So what I thought, just what I thought.
Finally,
the time has come. I'm starting to get kind of nervous. I felt the same way, resting on the keyboard, my hands started to shake.
Just a second.
The single word is sharpened blade. Wounded, I moved.
So then.
Here we go. Kyoko began typing, the words appearing as fast as I could read them. Can you tell us what you found out? Sure, I analyzed the files and extracted them all to the useful information I could find. One particular fact is I discovered was a certain plan had been put into effect here. To isolate the students of Hope Speak Academy and create a communal life for them. That was the stated goal of the plan, but it was meant to be more than just a normal school life. The students were intended to live out the rest of their lives, here. That's exactly the situation we found ourselves in. It's quite unthinkable, isn't it? And what's more, the one who came up with the plan was none other than the administrators of Hope Speak themselves. What? Wait, hold on. The reason we've been imprisoned here isn't the work of some psycho freak or criminal organization or whatever.
No way!
It was the school itself? That doesn't make sense! Why would they do that?
Just a second.
I don't think Alter Ego is finished. Perhaps we should hear the rest.
That's right.
It seems... Kitten! Cat. Ow! And she walks away. It seems like the reason they devised this plan was because of what happened 1 year ago. This is how they described the event. They said it was the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history.
Huh?
Columbine? What does that mean?
What
kind of name is that for something? Otherwise known as the tragedy, it was appeared some sort of devastating occurrence. Because of the tragedy, Hope Speak Academy was forced to discontinue its role as a school and close down.
I see,
says the blind man. things are finally starting to make sense. This is what this is. What this means is 1 year ago, this thing, this tragedy took place. And whatever it was, it forced Hope's Peak to shut down. From there, they decided to use the school as some staging ground.
That's right.
They planned a sequester of students. They planned to sequester the students here where they would live the rest of their lives. But why would they do that? Why would the Hope Speak administrators want to shut everyone in like this?
Hey.
And what could the tragic event have possibly been? And a flash Kyo could type the question. And an answer that we got. Sorry, I don't know. If that information was ever on this computer, it's gone now. I'm totally useless. I'm sorry. No! That's all he said.
What?
Then it really is the end. We get halfway through the answer and that's it?
Indeed.
It appears so disappointing. Oh wait! There's one other thing I forgot to mention. That I think it might be important. I believe it has to do with the mastermind. The mastermind! I dropped it. I dropped my controller. It went underneath my desk. Kyoko's fingers, blah blah blah. Did you figure out the mastermind's identity?
Sorry.
No, I still don't know. But I did find a clue, I think. The one leading the Hope's Peak staff, the one who finalized the plan to isolate you, was the Hope's Peak headmaster. And the same person may very well be the mastermind who planned all this out. And according to the flyers, the headmaster is a man in his late 30s. It seems possible, even likely, that he's somewhere in his school right now.
The headmaster?
The headmaster's in the school?
Okay.
Then that's gotta be the mastermind. I mean, Monokuma's been calling himself the headmaster, right?
Perhaps.
Which makes the real headmaster that much more suspicious.
For serious?
But if we break down that door to the room, we're dead, right? So what are we supposed to do? I'll find a way.
Huh?
matter what it takes, I will find the headmaster.
No matter what the cost.
So, Kyoko, what's going on?
I
can't explain why. I just know I have to find him. She has to. Kyoko, what's going on? When she heard about the headmaster, her reaction was almost violent.
So then,
we should see if Alter Ego has any more information. That seems to be her attempt to regain her composure, and she started typing again. Did you learn anything else? I'm sorry, that's everything I found. All the information on this laptop seems pretty old, and that's all I could do from here. I'm really sorry. Then it's really all over.
Hey.
Wait. Ah! Alter Ego seems to have more to say. Well, it is kind of a different topic, but I was wondering about something. I haven't seen Celeste, Fumi, or Taka since yesterday. A heavy silence filled the room. The only sound was the flat, precise clicking of Kyoko's typing. They're all dead.
Huh?
What? I see. Certainly, I knew that was a possibility, but
okay,
it really
then
happened?
Sorry.
There's no point in me getting depressed over things I can't do anything about.
Anyway.
Well, then, I guess that's it. That's it, a simple phrase that held so much meaning. She began typing again. You've done your job, thank you. I'm done? I guess I am, huh?
Okay,
then maybe
then
I'll take a little rest. I'm kind of tired. Good night. Goodbye, everyone. See you later. I love Chihiro. Chihiro is so fucking cute. With that, the computer entered sleep mode.
I see.
Says the blind man! So Alter Ego did everything he could.
Indeed.
We won't have to talk to him out all that much anymore.
But
I kind of feel sorry for him.
But
so you feel sorry, but he's just a computer program, right?
Well,
I know, but still, he did everything he could for us, you know?
Hmm.
I mean, yeah, but that's what a computer program is designed to do. You don't tell a computer, good job, every time you shut it down, do you? Well, no. But when we've talked to our alter ego, I guess I just... What is this? It didn't seem that way. I know what you mean. I feel the same way. Good job, computer. You're a great piece of machinery. I love you. I'm gonna update you one day with more stuff like detonades. I was gonna do a meme, but no. Hey, come on, it's just a program. You can tell the difference between a program and a friend, right? Shut up! Huh? I started thinking about why, blah, blah. Differentiate a person and an AI. Alter Ego isn't human. I know that. It's just a program running on a computer. But at the same time, I couldn't help but think of him as our friend.
That's right.
Yeah, there's no different. He's no different from us. He's still our friend. It's Shihiro. Fuck you.
How about
friendship
that?
Has no survival value. Instead, it gives value to survival. So anyway.
What?
Don't so anyway. It's that. It's totally smart and cool thing that I quoted from and I don't remember where.
Hey.
There's nothing more Alter Ego can do to help us. As such, his role is over. Am I wrong about that? No, but...
Just a second.
And frankly, I question the ease with which you decide who is and who and isn't your friend. Oh my god, the story's gotten off track. We should go over what Alter Ego said one more time. Yeah, good idea. Good, yeah.
What?
Why are they making us kill each other? Hmm. Alter Ego said that what happened 1 year ago is what started everything.
Well.
Yeah, he said the biggest, most awful, most hopeless event. No. I don't remember anything happening that you could describe that way. What about you guys? Columbine.
I'm sorry.
Columbine.
Anyway.
The answer is Columbine. A school shooting.
Least.
I'm telling you guys, the answer is always Columbine. 420. Blaze it. Blaze the school.
What?
Maybe all the students here were killed or something in a school shooting. Oh my god! Is this just this whole game is an allegory to fucking... Ah. It's a parallel. It's a cover up. That would explain why none of us knew that the school had been shut down.
I see.
Covering up something like that. I suppose it's not totally impossible. I feel like this. What is wrong with our government? Our taxes pay their salaries. They should be handling stuff like that. You sound like, oh my god. You sound like an American. Please stop.
Anyway.
Maybe. But right now there's only one path open for us.
So,
we have to find the headmaster of Hope's Peak.
Correct.
We have to find him and make him tell us everything. As long as we get our hands on him, I think. Kyoko. When she said headmaster, I got that feeling again.
Well.
But even that is a problem not easily solved. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right.
So
our business is done here. So for now, we should get out of here. Yeah, good idea.
Yep.
Then I... Is it really that dusty? Wait, I mean, I'm not waiting anymore. I'm not guarding it. Byakuya is gonna be so mad at me. Let's just go. But as we left the dressing room, someone was there waiting for us.
Ba-bum, ba-bum.
My heart's pounding away. It's pounding with anger. Oh no. You're not still mad about me. Oh, that little matter doesn't matter even a little. I'm a little jealous of you guys enjoying an indecent mixed bath that doesn't matter. But that doesn't matter either. It's building. I feel it building. My head's about to boil over with rage.
Please.
Let me center your chakra! Fucking love Hiro, but I hate him at the same time. Etch this on the wall of your brain, okay? When you do something to me, I do it right back! An eye for an eye, a fang for a fang!
Huh?
A fang devastation within our nation. Devastation within our nation. No, it's just the saying.
Hmm.
Oh, I see. But what's he talking about? I have no idea. Bing, bong, bong, bing, dong, ding.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited. Okay then, sweet dreams everyone. Good night, sleep tight.
Oh, that the bed bugs bite. I hate that.
Correct.
So it's nighttime.
Hey.
What does everyone want to do? Celeste is the one who suggested our nighttime rule, but she's gone now.
Hmm.
I think we should avoid being out at nighttime. I know it makes me feel better that way. Agreed.
It's true.
Well, very well. I gotta say, it's time for bed. So, everyone, back to their rooms. Monica was partying with. And she's gonna go. Anxious. Ah! Once I was back in my room, I got lost in thought. What we learned from Alter Ego kept spinning around in my head. And the administrators of Hopi had planned this all along, and we had the tragedy. Apparently the headmaster's one behind it, the mastermind. Mysteries make me worried, but I still gotta try to unravel them bit by bit. I'm sure that the road will be long and tough, and I don't have any other choice. Monokuma Theater! Oh, he added a crab. Let's talk a bit. Let's talk a bit about where I was at before I became a bear. At first, I was at a total loss. I just had no idea what I should become. A lady in our tech support department suggested I try being a shrimp. She was like, "Oh, the company's been trying to push for this forever. It's a really incredible offer." But as she laid out all the details, it turned out it wasn't a tiger prawn like I'd hoped, but a little popcorn shrimp. That's totally tiny. I wouldn't have been the world's smallest mascot. So then the lady started laughing at me. She was like, "You think we could do a tiger prawn on our budget?" So ultimately, I decided to become a bear instead. Why did Skip? Oh, because I was pressing B.
Good morning, everyone. It is now 7 a.m.
and
nighttime is
officially over.
Time to rise and shine. Get ready to greet another beautiful day.
Fucking love Monokuma's voice. Beautiful day. First things first, I'm the realist. But I hate Iggy Azalea because she's a fucking cunt. I needed to head to the dining hall. Owie and Tuck, no, you're Byakuya. Fuck you, Byakuya. You are a bitch. As I entered the dining hall, the first thing I saw was her. Why are you staring at Otoko?
What's your problem?
What, you think your eyes will rot just by looking at me? Fine, then don't look at me! I think he's just surprised to see you at the breakfast meeting is all.
Mm.
Indeed, it's been quite a while since you joined us.
Yeah,
what made you change your mind? Miyakia said he likes a girl to have some meat on her bones, so I'm gonna start eating. I'm gonna force it down into my stomach. I'm gonna eat till I drop.
Okay.
I refuse to lose.
Hina.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Other than that, it looks like Kyoko isn't here.
You know?
She said she'd come by later. later.
You know?
After you leave. She's not even trying to hide it anymore. I know I said I wanted you to show some backbone, but you didn't have to show her that much.
Just a second.
You're dirty, Makoto. Dirty. President of... President Dirty of Dirtlandia. Fucking love. You don't understand.
Just the
You're
worst.
Just a type... You're the type who takes the stairs of love 3 steps at a time, aren't you? I'm telling you, it's not like that. Just shut up already, Hina. You've been ruining your... You've been running your filthy mouth like that all morning.
Huh?
Filthy? Me? I'm a swimmer! Don't make me repeat myself.
Huh?
I'm not filthy. It's no use denying it. We all can see how disgusting you are.
Huh?
Shut up! You and that lusty body of yours, night after night. What? What is happening? Extracurricular activities! Only pleasure!
Please!
I'm not reading this!
Bastard!
Hey, come on.
I'm not okay.
You know?
Sexual. Pent up sexual frustration. You forgot a word. Anyway, you and Kyoko need to make up already, you know? Yeah, I know. I mean, of course I want things to get better as soon as possible. With everything that's been going on, I haven't had the chance to talk about what I saw. I need to talk to Sakura about it. Sakura! Sakura, what is it? Can you make some time later? I was hoping I could talk to you. Now that Kyoko's dumped him, Makoto's trying to win Sakura's heart. Are you in heat, Makoto? Don't care who they are, as long as they've got the right equipment.
Just the worst.
Oh my god, Prime Minister Wild Beast of Beastopia. Shut up!
Well.
For some reason, I've been feeling worn down these last few days.
Huh?
Are you sick? Did you get hurt?
Mm.
No, nothing serious. I've just had some minor aches and pains. Is that... because of that battle? It must be pretty bad if you got a rest. Are you sure you're okay?
Mm.
I'm sure a protein shake and some sleep would get me back on my feet.
You got it!
That's true! Protein is good for all kinds of stuff!
Hey.
You guys, like, worship protein. Is it like your god or something?
Okay.
Makoto, I don't know what it is you want to talk to Sakura! To Sakura about, but save it till tomorrow. She's in pain. Yeah, I got it.
I'm sorry.
You know?
Well, for now, let's eat. I'm kind of nervous.
Huh?
How come?
What's
your
problem?
I don't usually eat in front of other people. Ever since I was a kid, I'd eat by myself.
What the heck?
What about your family? Well, yeah, I used to live with my dad, my mom, and my mom.
Huh?
You had two moms? What? That's just how things were. That's like a serious issue. Just let it go. You're asking for trouble getting involved with other people's shit. How dare you speak to me with that disgusting mouth of yours?
Ooh.
Shut up! I'm just gonna eat. And if I don't, Kyoko will never show up. Pretty miserable situation, man. I scarfed down breakfast as fast as I could and immediately headed back to my room. It's no use! Okay. I'm gonna end it here, I think. How long have I been recording? Strictly an hour. And I'm gonna let it go a little bit longer until, like... not until somebody dies. Until, like... I talked to Sakura. Because I think the fourth one was a suicide. I don't remember. Yeah, I'm just saying, recently, why is it on caps lock? Never mind, I forgot what I was saying. I'll have to wait till tomorrow to confront what I said, by the way, but in a way, I'm kind of relieved. It takes a lot of courage to stand face to face with Sakura, an accuser of something. Free time! Okay. Report card. He's dead. You're alive. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. You're alive. I think I'm gonna hang out with Yasuhiro. I'm gonna hang out with Hiro. Wherever he is. He might be in his room. Oh wait, I could just check. I could just check with the map. Is he in his room? No, but that's Sakura. Oh, wait, no, I could just check with... Probably, everyone's probably in the fourth floor. Yep, Yasuhiro stairs to the fourth floor, so I have to go to the fourth floor. I'm just gonna speed this up. On the fourth floor now? No, this is... I was going the right way. You go to a bathroom. There you are.
Yo.
Did you need something, Makoto? Gasp! Verbal gasp. It better not be my life. Don't kill me. After life, protect me. Makoto, kill someone if you must. Don't kill me. Oh my god. On time with you.
Well,
don't mind if I had a heated discussion of cosmogamy. I learned about theories of the origin of the universe. Hiro and I grew a little closer today. Would you like give Hiro a present? Definitely! I don't have any colas. Glasses. I don't have any glasses. A vise. No. Robo Justice! Super Robo Justice! Sorry, but we can't let you give him that. It's Aw, dang. Then I won't give him anything.
Could it be...
Hey, Makoto. You know what I think? You and me meeting like this, it wasn't a coincidence.
Hmm.
I've got some good news for you. I'm gonna give you a psychic reading for a huge discount. Normally, it's $1,000 for 2 hours. Let's call it $900. It's only a $900 discount. Even that was too expensive.
Don't be mean.
Oh, come on. You should count yourself lucky that the ultimate clairvoyant was willing to tell your fortune. How about you don't for free?
Well?
I've got a 20% chance of accuracy. And no.
What the heck?
For real, don't make that face. Didn't you hear what I said? 20% of the time I'm right, every time. That includes natural disasters, election results, you name it. Don't you realize how amazing that is?
How about that?
Fine, I'll give you a special trial one. After all, I've already seen what the future has in store for you. Wait, what did you see?
Well?
Well, you won't believe what I saw. It would appear that the mother of your children and the mother of my children are the same woman! I refuse! Denied! Don't like it!
Doesn't matter! Right?
If you don't like it, that's just the way it is. 20% accurate, you said?
You know, at least.
I pray to everything holy that you're wrong! Please be wrong! Now, since that was a special trial run, I'm afraid I can't apply the discount. That'll be $1,000, please. Don't worry, you can pay me after we get out of here. Wait, hold on! There's no way you're gonna be right, right?
Hmm.
If you like, I could do a reading right now to see whether my reading was right or not. Naturally, additional fees will apply. Think about it, okay? Let me know as soon as you're ready for my service. Ha ha ha! Oh, he's gone. I don't have enough in my bank account to take another crack at it. No, I can't bring myself to pay for something like that. I can see how people could fall into that kind of cycle, though. It's so close. Ah, he's in debt. Here's a port card. You unlocked Lost in Thought. Give yourself a pat on the back. You've earned it. What does it do? Once we're all done, I headed back to my room for a while. More free time! But this time it is nighttime. No, but it's the daytime. I still have plenty of time. I just don't feel like I should go somewhere. Who should I go to? I think I'm gonna go to Byakuya, wherever he is. Not go to Kyokyo! Kyoko! To the warehouse. Nope. Mate. The others have flocked together as usual, I see. But they need to be careful. Growing too close will only cloud their judgment. Should I talk to Byakuya for a while? Yeah.
That's fine.
Fine, I don't mind allowing you to indulge him in my attention. I hope you appreciate this. I like Byakuya as a character. Not because I'm also a sociopath, just that he's a Not because he's a sociopath, but because he's a sociopath. Spend some time with Byakuya. Byakuya and I claim a little closer. Would you like to give- No! Not really! Is that it? He didn't want to say anything? Little bitch. Yeah. It's nighttime. It is officially nighttime!
Attention! Please gather in the gym as soon as you possibly can. Oh, no. Quickly!
Okay, time to head to the gym. Thank you. last one. Everyone else is inside. Are you gonna go in?
However,
I have a bad feeling about this. More than just a bat. More than just a feeling. I'm hooked on a feeling. Monokuma did call us together after all. Sakura.
Well, Dakota. Then.
Something happens to me. Hina. Huh? No,
I'm sorry.
Never mind.
So
I'm...
then.
Who would ever believe in someone who doesn't believe in themselves? It's time to go! Everyone must have heard the announcement and we were all gathered in the gym. It began. Whoo!
Well?
Okay, let's get this show on the road! You're about to give us the next motive presentation, aren't you?
Hmm? That's right.
You guys all together to present us with another motive, right? Is he right?
Huh?
We have to go through this again? No, not again! I can't take it anymore!
I see.
I'm impressed by your level of dismay. You've finally seen just how low on the totem pole of life you really are. No. That's not it at all. We're not here to talk about motive.
Today,
the reason why I gathered you all here, is so that I could get rid of my grudge. Your grudge?
Why?
We have a grudge against you, of course, but I don't recall you ever having a grudge against us. I told you yesterday, didn't I? An eye for an eye, a fang for a fang. Stop beating around the bush. Just tell us what you're talking about. Well, Byakuya, you've already told everyone how one of you might be working as a spy for me, right?
Come on.
Yeah, so what about it?
In other words...
I'd like to tell you about that spy. What?
Hey!
So guess what? The spy is actually Sakura Gami! Fuck! He said it so openly, I made it sound like it wasn't a big deal, even though he just revealed a huge secret.
What?
He said the spy is Sakura.
What are you talking about?
There's no way Sakura is a spy. Right, Sakura? Sakura?
Huh?
Sakura? And I might just make Sakura fulfill the promise she made me sometime soon. If she doesn't, I can't be responsible for what might happen to the hostage of mine. Anyway! That's all I wanted to say. What you guys choose to do with that information is up to you.
Kills,
Ruster,
kills,
spoil
kills.
Her, kill her, don't kill her, whatever.
I can't wait, I can't wait.
Either way, I can't wait. And just like that, he was gone. Doing Monokuma gives me a headache, because I can't be that psycho. I can't go from sociopath to psychopath that easily, okay? Finally, I understood what he had been trying. He's been talking about an eye for an eye, a fang for a fang. In other words, betrayal would meet with betrayal. Would be met with betrayal. Huh?
What does
that mean?
What?
Is it true? Has Ogre really been spying on us for the mask match?
What are you saying?
What are you saying? There's no way! But that is what that stuffed animal said, right? Whoa, whoa, whoa! Did you just go
wrong?
Well, he's wrong. There's no way!
Hey.
Well, Sakura, if he's wrong, all you have to do is tell us.
I'm sorry
I didn't tell you earlier.
Huh?
What? Oh no!
I'm sorry.
So you've been lying to us this whole time!
Huh?
It's not true, Sakura! You're being controlled! There's gotta be some reason! You didn't have a choice! She was forced to do it! Yeah, I'm sure Hina's right. The masterminds probably threatened her somehow, and Sakura had no choice but to do whatever she told her. Well, you're talking like you know that for a fact! Because I do know it for a fact. Because I saw it! I saw Sakura and Monokuma fighting. There that and that's where I heard it. Monokuma mentioned a hostage a second ago, right? During their fight, I heard Sakura say she decided to fight against the mastermind.
I see.
You saw that all? The mastermind took a hostage, so you were forced to swear loyalty to them, right? But in the end, you made up your mind to betray the mastermind.
What?
Which means Sakura isn't our enemy. She's a friend who we can trust without question. Is that it? Ridiculous. Do you live in some sort of alternate reality fairy tale?
Not possible.
She was the mastermind's tool. We absolutely cannot trust someone like that.
Impossible.
He's right. Oh my god, my ears just opened and it... Okay, they closed again. What? We can't just believe whatever she says right now. How can we even be sure she really did betray the mastermind? Maybe this is a double bluff. And she's doing exactly what the mastermind wants. Sakura would never do that! Okay then, Sakura. Okay, then Sakura. If you really have cut ties with the mastermind, tell us who they really are. Well...
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I can't. Even I don't want to know that.
What?
You don't know? That just makes you all the more suspicious.
Please!
She's telling the truth! You don't have to believe her!
Don't make me repeat myself.
Oh wait, do you have to? I didn't read it. Shut up! I'm not finished with her questioning her. Ah!
Come on!
Ah! Ah! Everything's going to shit! No, you've got that wrong! Objection! I just want to say objection. Next question. What's this about a promise? What did the mastermind order you to do? I was told to kill one of my friends. It suddenly felt like the temperature in the room had dropped 20 degrees. The weight of those words,
I see.
So even now, you've taken aim on our lives. You're wrong! I'm telling you, Sakura would never do that! You don't have to yell. You don't have to yell. We can hear you just fine. Don't you have an inside voice?
That's terrible.
Because you're not listening to me.
Wait.
Please stop. You don't need to defend me anymore. I have to take full responsibility for this.
However,
how do you intend to do that? By destroying the mastermind. What? I'm going to challenge them. Even if it means we both go down, I will defeat them.
I'm sorry.
That is how I intend to take responsibility. Hold on! Huh? What do you mean if you both go down?
Hina,
I'm sorry, I didn't tell you about this. Huh? What?
I didn't know
what to do. I went back and forth about confiding in you again and again.
Well.
But I was scared. I thought if I told you, you might think less of me. Sakura!
I'm sorry.
Ah! Sakura turned away and left the gym. And then... Seven of Diamonds. Yada 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 yada. Well, it's nighttime. We should all go to bed.
No
Hold
way.
On. This whole thing with Sakura is
Don't make
over.
Me repeat myself.
She's our enemy. There's nothing more to discuss.
That's
no!
Terrible.
Sakura is not our enemy!
Why?
Why doesn't anyone understand her?
What?
What is it you think you understand? You didn't even know she was who she really was.
Calm
Let
down.
It go for now, Hina. Talking about it isn't going to help anything.
Why?
But
anyway.
Go to your room. Cool down. We can continue this discussion tomorrow. That was just terrible. This is bad.
We were all so glad.
Okay, don't have to talk to Sakura anymore. Sakura is a spy. She's the traitor. Byakuya said Sakura is the enemy, but he's wrong. She's not the enemy. She's my friend, without a doubt. But what can I do? What can I do to make everyone believe in Sakura? How? Go to sleep. Monokuma Theater. After this Monokuma Theater, after this Monokuma Theater, I'm going to end the episode. As long as you're human, there will always come a point where you wished you could do things differently. Even a baseball player in the major leagues, even a soccer player touring Europe, even a famous singer who started her career as a backup dancer on a sketchy comedy show. She makes a brilliant debut, but instead of going for more, what was added? I don't even know. She makes a brilliant debut, but instead of going for more, she marries some third-rate actor and retires. Every human has regrets, has things they'd like to go back and change.
But I don't, because I'm a bear!
But I don't, because I'm a bear! Monokuma.
Good morning, everyone.
I don't care. I love Monokuma. I'm worried about Sakura. I need to hurry up and get to the dining hall. And I'm ending it here. We will go to the dining hall next episode of Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. Goodbye.